Twinkle, twinkle, little stars.
How I wonder what you are.
Up above the
like a diamond in the sky.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. I know exactly what you are.
We'll do it once again.
Okay.
Okay. Clap,
clap. Okay, 1, 2, 3, rolling.
I'm a professional amateur astronomer. Okay. So professional and amateur is actually looks contradictory,
yeah.
But actually amateur is a word which comes from amour, which means to love, and I love to do astronomy. So, and I now love to do it professionally.
The amateur astronomers is just a cohesive collection of free thinking loonies, you know, who are not part of the, who don't think they're part of mainstream society, or who think they're part of mainstream society, but the world doesn't think, the world at large thinks they're a bunch of loonies.
Cosmos gives me a higher sense of purpose. Looking at the stars is really like an enlightening. It is like connecting with a mysterious part of nature, like connecting with a huge, awesome universe.
Let me introduce this dog. What am I making here? So, I'm making a documentary on people who are passionate about astronomy. And they are all connected through the Amateur Astronomers Association. So now this is that place where all the people who are so passionate about astronomy are.
The sky is my treasure chest. It's there that I store diamonds and sapphires, emeralds galore, rubies of red, jades of golden, green topaz and opal, gems of all colors, jewels of all hue. The treasure's all mine, but I'll share it with you. Sometimes you can see sunrise on moon, you know? Yeah, sometimes. So this mountain range over here on moon, so when the moon is half, and the sun is slowly rising, if you keep watching for about half an hour, you will see more and more mountains, you know, catching light. So if the moon is half at this region, it will be in the evening time, or rather you should say it would be morning time. So if the sun is rising slowly from that side, more and more mountains will catch light, and you know, it will suddenly appear in your telescope such as this one. So you can see sunrise on. So using this, I photograph Jupiter, Saturn, Mars, Moon. In fact, this photo of Moon has been clicked with this. But this photo of Moon has been clicked in 24 parts and then stitched together.
Well, your line of business of manufacturing telescopes and such big, huge telescopes is not very popular in India as of now.
Yeah, I see a future in this.
How do you see the future? What do you see?
Because there is no competition and nobody is building. So I am sort of pioneer in this field, in India at least.
This observation on wealth, there will be a lot of people who do not own a telescope, but they will be able to watch things.
See, astronomy is really, amateur astronomy is really a community game. So even if somebody has a telescope, he is not so much interested in going out alone and, you know, working all night. But if you have a group, so there will be fun and sharing. And sharing of knowledge, sharing of resources. So it's a community activity. I have several cameras, Canon 5D, 450D, 1000D. So this photograph is consisting of individual shots taken over the entire night. So 9 hours and 41 minutes, and 852 frames have, individual frames has contributed to this photo. I call this photograph the pillars of creation. Actually, these are pillars in construction stage of an observatory, the largest observatory in India. This place is going to house the telescope, which is 3.6 meters, very large, and the place is Devsthal. Twinkling stars. So music pehle dhoondna maine. बहुत सारे गाने सुन के मेरे को लगा कि कौन सा which one resembles twinkling stars.
and after that Mars, traveling the sky like pretty little stars. Then comes Jupiter, and thereafter Saturn, crossing the sky and making a pattern. And then comes Uranus, and lastly Neptune. That's the place that we would like to go very soon. Oops, but wait a minute, we've forgotten Pluto. Though it's no longer a planet, that is where we all want to go. You know? Oh, yeah, Buddha.
I'm an intellectual property lawyer. I work with a prominent NCR firm. And in my spare time, I teach my daughter. I try and teach her science and other things. And I'm also an amateur astronomer, so.
Totally changed the way I am as a person. I think it changes anyone who seriously pursues astronomy as a hobby.
Come here.
Because when you look at the expanse of the universe and you see its wonders, you look through the telescope, you marvel at it, you know, the sheer romance of the hobby comes out. If you pursue it seriously on any angle, say observational or photographic astronomy or whatever,
yeah,
you then learn a lot about the hobby itself. But even the sheer joy and the virgin romance of it, it captivates you to an extent that it affects how you live your life.
I remember you were there in Varanasi in 2009, yeah, eclipse, and this was of course my first eclipse, first total eclipse. So the first thing that I felt when I watched the totality happening was that how small I am in front of these gigantic objects in the space. So have you ever felt that, and share your experience of?
Yeah, I mean, I feel that every time I look at any object through a telescope, I feel that I'm just an insignificant, you know, spoke in this wheel of infinite spokes, and that I'm nothing, and that I'm just meant to observe and enjoy. So I got that feeling when I looked at the totality. So I mean, you always feel when you do astronomy that why are there borders? I mean, if people are on spacecraft above the Earth, they don't see any borders. They just see the contours, the physical contours of the continents. And the clouds and the water and the blue and the pale blue dot that it is. It's not a dot, it's much bigger than that for them. They're not that far away.
The wise Jedi Master Yoda from Star Wars.
Star Wars is Vishnu's favorite.
Yeah, my all-time favorite movie series.
Oops.
Star Trek and
Oops.
Star Wars. I live and die for Star Trek and Star Wars.
Radhika,
let her get all the stuff.
No, they're all coming.
Yeah, okay.
You mentioned all of them, they're all here.
Hey, aja, leke aja. There, that's my daughter's collection of stuffed toys.
No, you don't have to go inside those. No.
अच्छा पूर्वी योडा को बोलो हाय कम अरे गाइस शी इनसाइड दैट केयरफुल नॉट ऑन द एज सो आई फाउंड दिस लवली लिटिल क्यूटी स्टफ टॉय एंड आई हैड टू बाय फॉर माय डॉटर सो आई डोंट केयर अबाउट अदर थिंग्स बट आई मेक श्योर शी नोज योडा यू नो वन ऑफ द रियली सिली थिंग्स दैट रघु डजंट अलाउ अस टू स्क्रीन स्टार ट्रेक एंड स्टार वॉर्स मूवीज ही इज ऑलवेज इनटू डूइंग ऑफिशियल थिंग्स इन द प्लैनेटेरियम
नो
आई चिल आउट अ बिट मोर रघु एंड से Now we'll show Star Trek 2 episodes today.
I've been to observations with him.
Hmm.
I went to Ranikhet. Then I went even to the planetarium. I've been a couple of times.
Okay,
but,
she has a name for that.
I mean, I started to understand a bit more about, you know, so what's the fascination at looking at all this stuff and doing the stuff that you do.
Hmm.
But have I been able to take it as a hobby? No, and I don't think that's important because he has a right to have his own hobbies and it's not important that, you know, as a family, we have to have like the same hobby, but I'm hoping that
she
picks it up. But yeah, sometimes I would get irritated, and I still do. Like he just told me, "Kal evening, I'm at the planetarium," and I'm like,
I told the observation was cancelled, but I have to go to the planetarium.
Yeah.
So she's been going.
I want to go to Ambi Mall, and he wants to go to the planetarium. So he's going to go to the planetarium tomorrow. So I know when he decides he's going to go, and he needs those two. So we have a deal that 2 weekends a month he's allowed to go to the planetarium.
Yeah.
Jupiter. You see her version of Jupiter, not the car. She'll make the surface. Bano.
Yeah. Those must be the rings.
Yeah.
I want to somehow conceive a project where I end up studying and trying to attract investment into studying weather phenomena.
light pollution phenomena and somehow coming up with an algorithm on very accurate weather and seeability predictions, which can help astronomers determine beforehand what kind of projects they could possibly execute from a location at any given time on any given day.
Bye bye. Say bye bye, everyone. Plankis though. Plankis Edu.
You know, it's very difficult to describe what goes in your mind when you actually see those stars, because they are so beautiful. It's like when you see a beautiful woman, you don't really have words to describe the beauty. It's absolutely the same with the stars. It's so beautiful and pretty that you can't really describe it. There are no words to describe.
On the day of the eclipse, we are all seated in on the terrace, and someone is counting 10, 9, 8, 7, and 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And suddenly that, just the moment, Guru Prasad used to be there, and he used to say first contact, and that was the moment I saw safely with my telescope. There was a filter attached on a camera so that no harmful radiations can come. And I saw the first contact, and that was the most beautiful time, you have goose pimples. I think the passion of astronomy started long back when I was 4 years old. This was about 1984. And we used to have power cuts. So once I remember during a power cut, I was looking at the stars. The sky was full of stars just outside my home. And I remember, like, I was gifted a book by my sister about astronomy. And I used to look at the pictures of Saturn painted by a very famous artist. It was a depiction of how Saturn looks like from the moon Titan. Yeah. That was one of the most fascinating aspects which got me started. But it was like the joy of seeing the stars in the night sky. Carl Sagan in his Cosmos, he mentioned, like, human beings just inspect a colony of bacteria using a microscope and bacteria don't even get to know. So we could be that primitive in front of an extraterrestrial civilization. So it could be that they are there, but they have not approached us. And it could be also like we are all aliens, because no, really speaking, like, just think of it, like, maybe the life came on Earth with a comet seeding the Earth long back, because we don't know whether the first primitive molecules were made here on Earth, or so it could be we are all aliens also.
Carl Sagan was, of course, a very popular atheist as well. He never considered that there is a God. So has astronomy affected your religion, and how has it affected at all?
Okay. Carl Sagan, I'm not sure whether he was an atheist or what was his stand. I don't know. But question of has astronomy affected my religion? I think in a way, yes. Astronomy is like more, astronomy has made me more of a humanist, like a human being centric, rather than God centric or supernatural power centric. It's more of a reality centric, and because the universe is very fascinating. I think AAA had a great influence in my life, meeting really cool people who would sit out, drink tea and discuss universe and have a lot of fun, go out for night observations. So that had a very profound impact.
We were supposed to meet a bunch of amateur astronomers at the Damdama Lake, but the weather has hampered those plans. Now we'll be meeting them at the Nehru Planetarium.
It was the year 2004, that was the first time I visited the Amateur Astronomers Association, and Venus was coming in front of the Sun, and there were a lot of telescopes around the planetarium lawns, and I went into the planetarium and saw these people showing the Sun with telescopes. It was such an awesome experience. And then I got to know about the AAA there, and I joined the association since. And it's been good 8, 9 years now.
They're by far the biggest binoculars you'll find in India. This was not given to Jawaharlal Nehru, it was actually given to Indira Gandhi by Nippon Corporation in the memory of Jawaharlal Nehru. Because he is very famous to be an amateur astronomer. He loved astronomy.
Please pretend that you are looking at the moon.
Pretend, you don't have to pretend.
Yes,
you can see the moon.
इसका फील्ड ऑफ व्यू बड़ा है
अब और निकाल दे तो पांच मिनट के लिए कोई कुछ नहीं करेगा
देखो
As a child, I used to feel that the things that you, the little shapes that you see on the moon are very similar to the, you know, continents that you see over. And I used to think that it's a mirror. And you actually get to see the entire Earth on the moon. And then I used to be surprised at sometimes when I would not see the entire moon. And I couldn't figure out why that was happening. And my mom, the cutest person in this whole world, said, beta, aapne kuch na kuch gadbad kiya hoga. To Chanda mama aapse naraaz ho gaye, to wo chup gaye. And it almost invariably happened that every time I was naughty during the day, I would notice that the moon was missing a part. I was like, man, inko kaise pata chala ki maine aaj kuch gadbad kiya hai?
Unfortunately, the weather turned out to be bad today.
But
that is astronomy, and it happens very frequently. There are only in a perfect world, we would have all the night times to be beautiful and without the clouds. But today, unfortunately, it's clouded out. We couldn't see. We just saw the moon. We took out our binoculars, the Nikon binoculars, but we couldn't unfortunately see anything but the moon. But I'm sure a lot of these new guys who came here today saw the moon and enjoyed it. And there are days like this very frequently in astronomy. But we have to live with this.